Take a look, and it's really worthwhile. Wow. Our manager here has put on a fantastic display.
Thank you very much for coming. Thank you to Philip Gevick from Gevick Gallery, and I just want to say a hand for Klaus and Beverly, who were just amazing.
You're welcome. My pleasure that you've been here.
And don't forget, for those who just arrived, there's a gorgeous, beautiful exhibit inside of 11 paintings done by Albert Chiariandini back in the 60's, so you have to go in and take a look at them. And we are proud and happy to introduce a wonderful musician, Sebastian Agnello. Where are you? Sebi, where are you? Sebi. Anyway, Sebastian, who is just adorable and everybody loves him, was in a band called the Lords of London. And he told me this story, how he was coming down to Yorkvlle when he was 13 years old and nobody knew how young he was. But we are proud to have Sebastian play with us today. So welcome, Sebastian. In 2 seconds.
Thank you, Linda. Thank you, everybody. Oh, that's great. Yeah. No, that's perfect.
How are you doing?
Good. Oh, yeah. Yes, we're already. I'm already introduced. Thank you, Linda. Thanks, everybody. And Joan. What a great exhibition. All those great portraits of actual real people in Yorkvlle. And I figured I'm going to keep with the theme and I'm going to do a song about more real people from Yorkvlle. Do you guys remember Norm Elder's gallery? at Bay and Scholard. Well, I had many months there. And one of the guys there, a great character by the name of Terry Baxter, used to be known as the Worm, spelled W-E-R-M-E. He was my road manager for about 18 months, and I wrote a song about him, which was on my very first album that was banned back in 1970. The album was called Head Roach, and after I sing you a couple of songs, you'll know why it was banned. But anyway, here's a song about a real Yorkvlle character, Ballad of the Worm. Once there was a sweet young boy who ran away from home, came to the city, hungry and all alone. Wandered round the lonesome city, money he had none, till a nice young man took him home. There he turned him on. He stayed with him for a year or two, until he didn't need a helping hand. Then he left to fulfill his dream and joined a psychedelic band. He worked until the hassle started, but still he can't explain why the band split and he was on the road again. He looked for work, but he couldn't find none, and by now the winter had come. He went back to school, but oh, what a fool, he was soon in the city again. Now he drives a cab for the city people. It is the only job he could obtain. But it won't be long, I can feel it in my blood, he'll soon be on the road again. He'll start a band and he'll make it stick, 'cause he has the knowledge of a worm. But soon I know that it will split and he will have to go home to Norman and Valerie and all the speed freaks at the gallery. Ballad of the Worm. Yes, Yorkvlle was known for peace and love and lots of great music. But you know the one thing that always stuck in everybody's mind? Drugs. Of course, around the corner here we had the famous grab bag. And of course, around the corner there on Scholard we had the head shop. So here's a song about those places. Let's go to the drugstore and get some DMT. Let's go to the drugstore and we'll get some LSD. Let's go to the drugstore and we'll get some STP. Let's go to the drugstore and I'll buy an ounce of weed. Let's go to your backyard and look for your stash. Let's go to your backyard, 'cause I'd like to smoke some hash. Let's go to your backyard, or you're gonna get a lash. Let's go to your backyard, 'cause I'd like to get smashed. Let's go to the village, and there we will get stoned. Let's go to the village, 'cause I'm straight as a bone. Let's go to the village, and we'll probably pop some dope. You better get me stoned, or I won't call you no more. Okay, have I offended everybody by now? It's okay, it gets worse. Very first time that John Prine played in Canada was the riverboat again across the street. And I came to see him, and I used to be allowed to drive in those days. I had a 1965 MGB, and you know, right across from the riverboat, there used to be an indoor parking garage, right? So I was all excited. I was going to see John Prine, and so I parked the car in the parking garage, and we had a great time. It was a great gig, etc., etc. I was a little bit buzzed, just a little. Show's over. I went to get my car, and I guess I didn't read the sign right that said that the garage closed at 10:30. So I couldn't get my car. My wallet was in the car. I had no money. But it was a nice night, so I ended up walking from Yorkvlle to Jones and Danforth. So in honor of that, I'd like to do you a John Prine song that he sang that night. Woke up this morning, put on my slippers, walked in the kitchen and died. And oh, what a feeling when my soul hit the ceiling and right up into heaven I did ride. When I got there, they did say, John, it happened this way. You slipped up on the floor and hit your head. Now all the angels say, just before you passed away, these were the last words that you spoke. Please don't bury me down in that cold, cold ground. Well, I'd rather have them cut me up, pass me all around. Throw the brain and hurricane at the blind can have my eyes. You have to take both of my ears if they don't mind the size. Welcome my stomach to Milwaukee if they run out of beer. Put my socks in a cedar box, just get them out of here. Well, if you missed a mile off and have my arms, look out, I've got your nose. Sell my heart to the young man and give my love to Rose. So please don't bury me down in the cold, cold ground. Well, I'd rather have them pump me up, pass me all around. From a rain and a hurricane, if the blind can have my eyes, the deaf can take both of my ears if they don't mind the size. Give my feet to footloose, wild and fancy free. Give my knees to the needy, don't pin that stuff on me. Well, hand me down my walking cane, it's a sin to tell a lie. Send my mouth way down south and kiss my ass goodbye. Oh, please don't bury me down in cold, cold ground. Well, I'd rather have them cut me up, pass me all around.
Oh man, it's a lot of souls to do
it. Yeah, keep your nose in the river, please. Playing this song, especially for your favorite, it's a little... Anyway, it doesn't matter. Dave and I are probably the biggest Phil Oaks fans ever. And yes, I saw Phil at the Riverboat, his very last time in Toronto, and just a couple of years before he passed away. A great theme of the 60s, of course, was the Vietnam War. And what better song about that than Phil Oaks' Draft Dodge Rag. I just gotta remember it. God, it's only been 40 years since I sang this song. Well, I'm a typical American boy from a typical American town. I believe in God and Senator God, keep it on the Castro down. But when it's time to serve, you know I said, better dead than bread. But when I got to the draft board, buddy, this is what I said. Sarge, I'm only 18.
18, I got a ruptured spleen, and I always carry a purse. I got eyes like a bat, my feet are flat, my asthma's getting worse. Think of my career, my sweetheart dear, my poor old invalid aunt. Besides, I ain't no fool, I'm going to school and working in a defense plant. I got a dislocated disc and a racked up back. I'm allergic to flowers and bugs. And when the bone shell hits, I have an epileptic fit and I'm addicted to 1,000 drugs. I got the weakness woes, can't touch my toes, I can hardly bend my knees. And if the enemy gets close to me, you know I'll probably sneeze. Sorry, I'm only 18, I got a ruptured spleen, and I always carry a purse. I got eyes like a bat, my feet are flat, my asthma's getting worse. Think of my career, my sweetheart dear, my poor old invalid aunt. Besides, I ain't no fool, I'm going to school and working in a defense plant. I hate Chow online, and I hope he dies, but there's something you gotta see. That if somebody's gotta go over there, that someone isn't me. So I wish you well, Sarge, give them hell, kill me 1,000 or so. If you ever get a war without blood and gore, I'll be the first to go. Sarge, I'm only 18, I got a ruptured spleen, and I always carry a purse. I got eyes like a bat, my feet are flat, my asthma's getting worse. Think of my career, my sweetheart dear, my poor old invalid aunt. Besides, I ain't no fool, I'm going to school and working in a defense plant. Woo, that's a mouthful. All these protest songs, you know, but after about 20 years or 30 years, I sort of got a little bit tired of protest songs. So I wrote a song called, I Don't Want to Protest Anymore.
Well, I don't want to protest anymore. I'd rather see you dancing on the floor. Move your body till it gets sore. Cause I don't want to protest anymore. Well, all my friends, they have gone commercial, and they play at all the local bars. They dream of being on Johnny Carson. Why, they're already acting like stars. Well, Bobby Dylan, he found religion, but I do wish he'd make up his mind. He used to be a Jew, and then he was a Christian, and then he was a Jew. I wonder how long this fight will last this time. Well, Danny Marks, he's really into rock and roll, and I do believe he's on the right track. You should see the way he rolls around the floor, plays a Stratocaster behind his back. Be that commercial, and I don't want to play guitar behind my back. I hope my friends make money by the bushel, and I pray they don't have a heart attack. I said I wouldn't protest anymore, but I guess I have to give it some more thought. I used to be younger, but not no more. Maybe later Act 2 can be bought.
Which brings me all the way up to 1986.
Like only yesterday, we would protest in the street. Down with war and up with love, I guess we were naive. We thought that we could change the world. Communication was our tool. But now that we're at the edge of power. It feels like deja vu. Some folks said that God was dead. Others said he was on our side. But how in the hell can you kill God unless he committed suicide? We used to shake our heads at our unenlightened friends. But now watching the TV screen, we're acting just like them. The more things change, the more they remain the same. The more that we learn, life seems such a game. We turned our backs on Biafra. We were cheering for the Viet Cong. Then we cheered for Nicaragua. And look what happened in Afghanistan. After all the history we've been through, at least we still have the right to be wrong. But for how long? Well, I've learned a lesson in diplomacy. Never speak what you think is true. Join a special interest group. They'll do your thinking for you. And don't talk to me about equality when we want our special rights. And don't talk to me about unity. We can't win unless the people divide. The more things change, the more they remain the same. The more that we learn, life seems such a game. We turned our backs on Biafra. We were cheering for the Viet Cong. Then we cheered for Nicaragua. And look what happened in Afghanistan. After all the history we've been through, at least we still have the right to be wrong. But for how long? For how long? Deja vu. All right, I'm going to do one more song. I'm going to bring you all the way up to date to 2015. This song is all about me. Well, yesterday morning, I was laying around in my house. I've got this book with pictures of Madonna naked. I was checking it out. When just then a friend of mine comes through the door. She said, I never paid you for a scumbag before. She said she could never want to see me no more. And I still don't know why. I think I'm an alright guy. I think I'm an alright guy. I just wanna live until I've gotta die. You know I ain't perfect, but God knows I tried. I think I'm an alright guy. I think I'm alright. Well, I may be a bit lewd, and you know sometimes I smoke just a little dope. But hey, it ain't like I'm going on TV tearing up pictures of the Pope. Well, I get a little crazy and I get a little drunk. But it ain't like I've got a bunch of bodies in my trunk.
My old man used to call me a no-good punk, and I still don't know why. I think I'm an alright guy. I think I'm an alright guy. I just wanna live until I'm gonna die. You know I ain't perfect, but God knows I try. I think I'm an alright guy. I think I'm alright.
You know, just the other week, a couple of cops pulled me over in front of Grossman's bar. They shined their light on me, then they ordered me out of Kim's car. Hey man, I was only kidding when I called them a couple of dicks, but still they made me do the stupid human tricks. Now I'm stuck in this jail with a bunch of dumb hicks, and I still don't know why. I think I'm an alright guy. I think I'm an alright guy. I just wanna live until I've gotta die. You know I ain't perfect, but God knows I try. I think I'm an alright guy. I think I'm alright. I think I'm an alright guy. I think I'm alright.
Thank you very much. Thank you, Linda. And I guess a little plug for myself. Every Monday night, I host an Acoustic Mondays at the Black Swan Tavern on the Danforth. Come on, drop in and have a couple of shots of tequila with me. Thank you. Take care.
Have a little finale with everybody, and we'll find a song that everybody knows, so don't leave. And don't forget to come in and see the beautiful paintings, if you haven't seen them yet, by Albert Chiariandini. I finally learned how to pronounce his name properly. Come into the gallery, see the beautiful hippie paintings, and enjoy the next few minutes.